So now we know about the civil disobedient movement, which was launched in the year 12th March 1913. Actually, in the year 1927, the Nehru Report had demanded for the autonomous status for the British rule, and it was rejected by Muslim League because of the non-inclusion of their demand in the report. So this led to the breakup of the Congress and the Muslim, and thus this Nehru Report was rejected by the British government. And similarly, in the year 1929, the Congress session was held at Lahore, which was presided by Jawaharlal Nehru as the president. And in that meeting, it was decided to hold, that is 26th January, to be observed as a Purna Swaraj Day. But even that was also failure. So later on, it was decided that a civil disobedient movement should be launched against the British. So what is the civil disobedient movement? It's a movement against the British order. Okay. So, Mahatma Gandhiji put forward before the government, that is British government, certain condition, which included reducing the land tax and again the abolition of the salt tax. It was in those days, the salt was but manufactured by the British. That means it was a monopoly of the government. The government had the complete right to manufacture the salt, and it was not let to the individual to manufacture. So the Indians had placed before the government to abolish the salt tax, but the British refused to do that. So Gandhiji, now in order to start the movement against this, he with the idea of Dandi March, he started the salt satyagraha. So this was started in the year 12th March 1930. Gandhiji with his 78 followers, he left Sabarmati and reached Dandi, that is on the west coast of Gujarat. Okay, and it said that they walk around the 375 kilometers in 25 days and violated the salt law and prepared the salt. So Mahatma Gandhi reached Dandi, prepared salt, violated the law. Okay, and on the line of Mahatma Gandhi, even the local leaders also violated the salt law, and the movement quickly spread to the other part of the country also. In Peshawar, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, he led the movement, and in Sholapur, even the textile workers, they led on strike, and along with the other residents, even the they burned the liquor shop and other symbols of the government. Soon enough, this movement has created a nationwide impact and had spread like a wildfire, and it has spread to all parts of the country. As the reports and the photograph of this movement had begun to spread and appear in the newspapers and in across the country, the support for the Indian freedom struggle also started growing. Okay, so this is about the civil disobedient movement launched by Gandhiji against the imposition of the tax on the salt. Now we know about the Quit India movement, which was launched on 8th August 1942. Between 1939 and 1945, the world witnessed, as you all know, the Second World War. The Second World War began from 1939 to 1945. And in 1945, the British government tried to seek the cooperation of the Indians in the war. Okay, so in March 1942, the government sent a commission headed by Stafford Cripps. Okay, and he approached the nationalist to seek the permission, that means seek their support. But the mission failed to get the support of the nationalist. But after Cripps' mission failed, in August 1942, Gandhiji launched Quit India movement. Immediately after he announced this movement, British arrested him. However, the younger activists like Jayaprakash Narayan and others, they continued the movement, and you could see the widespread strikes and other things in the different part of the world. Okay, which took the government more than 1 year to suppress. That is, the British government took 1 year to put down this movement. In June 1945, when Gandhiji came out, but was released, and therefore he came out from the prison. There afterwards, Punjab and Sindh widely spread. So Gandhiji then held a meeting, a series of meeting with the Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the leader of the Muslim League, in order to see that to come to the some kind of compromise between the Congress, but it was a failure. And again in 1945, when the Labour Party came to power in Britain, Viceroy also tried to convince, that means he tried to bring the mutual understanding between the Muslim League and the Congress. But even that was also failure too. Later in the year 1946, Cabinet Mission was appointed in order to bridge the gap between the two parties, that is Muslim League and the Congress. Even it failed to attain the compromise in the federal system of government, and even they failed to agree to autonomy of these provinces. Later on 16th August 1946, Muhammad Ali Jinnah announces a direct action day to press the demand for the Pakistan. So in February 1947, Lord Mountbatten, he became the Viceroy. And even Lord Mountbatten also tried his last attempt to compromise these two groups, that is Muslim League and the Congress, but it failed. So when he had announced that is the British would transfer the power with the creation of the separate country of Pakistan, the formal transfer of the power would be made on 15th August 1947. They could see that festivity, the day of independence, was celebrated throughout the country. But Mahatma Gandhi was in Kolkata under fasting. Okay, so like this, on August 14th, 1947, Pakistan became independent. That means it became free from India. And India became independent on August 15th, 1947. And Nehru became the first Prime Minister. And the British, who had come to India for trade, had ruled India for 200 years and left it economically and politically weak. Okay. Thus, the freedom struggle on the Indians finally forced the Britishers to leave India. Thus, 15th August 1947, on which the foreign rule ended, is unforgettable in the history of India.